Let go absolutely. After failure on my part to dry up any drunks. Dr. Silkworth reminded me of Professor William James's observation that truly transforming, spiritual experiences are nearly always founded on calamity and collapse. Stop preaching at them, Dr. Silkworth said, and give them the hard medical facts first. This may soften them up a depth so that they will be willing to do anything to get well. Then they may accept those spiritual ideas of yours, and even a higher power. AA Comes of AGE, pages 13. More than comfort. When I am feeling depressed, I repeat to myself statements such as these: pain is the touchstone of progress. Fear no evil. This too will pass. This experience can be turned to benefit. These fragments of prayer bring far more than mere comfort. They keep me on the track of right acceptance. They break up my compulsive themes of guilt, depression, rebellion, and pride. And sometimes they endow me with the courage to change the things I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. Grapevine, March 1962. Selfish? I can see why you are disturbed to hear some AA speakers say, AA is a selfish program. The word selfish ordinarily implies that one is acquisitive, demanding, and thoughtless of the welfare of others. Of course, the AA way of life does not at all imply such undesirable traits. What do these speakers mean? Well, any theologian will tell you that the salvation of his own soul is the highest vocation that a man can have. Without salvation, however we may define this, he will have little or nothing. For us, if AA, there is even more urgency. If we cannot or will not achieve sobriety, then we become truly lost, right in the here and now. We are of no value to anyone, including ourselves, until we find salvation from alcohol. Therefore, our own recovery and spiritual growth have to come first, a right and necessary kind of self-concern. Letter, 1966. Whose responsibility? An AA group, as such, cannot take on all the personal problems of its members, let alone those of non-alcoholics, in the world around us. The AA group is not, for example, a mediator of domestic relations, nor does it furnish personal financial aid to anyone. Though a member may sometimes be helped in such matters by his friends in AA, the primary responsibility for the solutions of all his problems of living and growing rests squarely upon the individual himself. Should an AA group attempt this sort of help, its effectiveness and energies would be hopelessly dissipated. This is why sobriety, freedom from alcohol, through the teaching and practice of AA's 12 steps, is the sole purpose of the group. If we don't stick to this cardinal principle, we shall almost certainly collapse. And if we collapse, we cannot help anyone. Letter, 1966. A full and thankful heart. One exercise that I practice is to try for a full inventory of my blessings and then for a right acceptance of the many gifts that are mine, both temporal and spiritual. Here I try to achieve a state of joyful gratitude. When such a brand of gratitude is repeatedly affirmed and pondered, it can finally displace the natural tendency to congratulate myself on whatever progress I may have been enabled to make in some areas of living. I try to hold fast to the truth that a full and thankful heart cannot entertain great conceits. When brimming with gratitude, one's heartbeat must surely result in outgoing love, the finest emotion that we can ever know. Grapevine, March 1962.